We are one of the only biological stations in the world that has been running for over 100 years. So we've had scientists and students asking questions and exploring our environments for a long time. And we've been running educational programs focused on a variety of organismal as well as environmental issues. The natural world is changing rapidly due to a whole bunch of different global change factors. We know that wintertime precipitation is changing, and that's going to change the amount of nutrients in our lakes and rivers and streams. We really need to be helping students understand these places in order to make informed decisions going forward. We bring students here and we embed them in the environment. We have them doing research here. They ask questions, they collect data, they analyze those data, they talk to their peers. They meet in our dining hall with scientists from all over the world to talk about their results, and they really grow as scientists.
Historically, and even today, now in courses, students are challenged to develop their own research project. They can hit the ground running. They don't have to go out and collect this data to answer this question because they have it. It allows you to ask these sort of more refined, nuanced questions.
The biological station encourages students to learn from the place rather than about the place. It makes them think when they're standing out in the field doing their work. What role am I playing in this?
You get to have that hands-on experience and learn in a completely different way that I don't think you could ever get on campus. Learning from the land gives people a deeper respect for the land that they're on. Everything that we do has an effect on everyone else.
We're bringing in writing, we're bringing in art. To me, it's like the connective tissue between so many disciplines that ought never to have been separated, whether your subject are plants or people or landscapes or water. When you change that relationship to respecting that being as a teacher instead of just a subject, it changes the information you're collecting from data to understanding the story of whoever you're studying.
I thought that I wanted to be a molecular biologist. It was coming to the biostation that made me realize that what I really wanted to be doing was making policy. It wasn't just about being able to memorize things or define them, but figure out how research is translated and is used by not only policymakers, but politicians, and then the community then interprets and uses that information. It changed the trajectory of my life, and I think that there are many people who can say the same thing.
The biological station is really unique, but at the end of the day, when I think of what we do that's really powerful is that we train students and we send them out into the world to ask these sorts of questions and understand the places where they live. We can change here and we can change our understanding, and we provide data that is so important to papers and science and policy, but we also create these individuals that go on and do incredible things. I'm really excited about what we've accomplished over the last 100 years, but I'm way more excited about where we're going in the next 100 years.